A spirited effort has been made to combat coronavirus across the world. The global epidemic of tuberculosis also calls for concern. Hence, March 24th each year is earmarked as World Tuberculosis Day. This is designed to build public awareness about tuberculosis and efforts to eliminate the disease. Nigeria is among the 14 high-burden countries for TB and multi-drug-resistant TB. The country is ranked 7th among the 30 high-TB burden countries and 2nd in Africa. And joining me in the studio this morning to shed more light on this is Dr. Bolanle Olusola-Faleye, and she's the Technical Director of SHOPS Plus TB program. Thank you for joining us, Doctor.
Thank you for having me.
Now, to start with, what's your assessment of the prevalence of tuberculosis across, the most important part of Nigeria right now?
Okay, so like you rightly said, tuberculosis is very endemic in Nigeria. Nigeria is among the 30 most burdened TB countries with TB in the world. We are number one in Africa,
okay,
and number six in the world. And it is unfortunate that people don't detect as many cases as we should in the health system in Nigeria because the level of awareness is low. So TB is very is common in Nigeria, but is not as detected as it should be. We are finding only about 1/4 of the cases of TB we should report every year. So out of the estimated 429 TB cases in Nigeria, we find only about 120,000 on a yearly basis.
And then how prevalent is it in the world? Nigeria, you say it's number six
in the world? Number six in the world.
And then in Africa, it's number one.
Number one.
And that's some scary statistics right there.
That's a reality.
Okay, now tell us, can you shed more light on what tuberculosis is and the common type that's prevalent in Nigeria?
Okay, so tuberculosis is an infectious disease. It is called by bacteria. It's a chronic disease. So it means that it's not acute, like COVID virus, for example.
So when you say chronic, is it terminal? Can it be terminal?
It can be terminal, but it is treatable,
okay,
and it's very curable. And that is the unfortunate part of it, because if we can find them, we can treat them.
Okay.
So it is common, but it is not reported. It's either of two things. Either we are not detecting, that is, doctors in the health system are not detecting TB at all, because they are not suspecting, they don't have a high index of suspicion, or we are finding them but not reporting them, but they are two different things. The channel of reporting for TB cases is through the National TB Program and then to the WHO, who now gives the country figure for Nigeria. But if doctors are treating TB in their consulting rooms but are not reporting to the National TB Program, then it's underestimated and it is not reported. And the implication is that there's transmission going on because it's also infectious.
Oh, wow. Now, as a health expert, as a doctor, what would you say are the findings or your findings or the causes of tuberculosis?
So tuberculosis is infectious, meaning that it's caused by a germ. It is bacterial, it's a bacterial infection. And it is airborne, meaning that it is spread through the air. So when people that have TB cough or sneeze or talk or even sing, they can actually discharge aerosols that have TB.
Just like the novel coronavirus.
Just like coronavirus,
yes,
into the air. And then because it is airborne, it stays in the air for a longer period, probably longer than coronavirus. That's the difference. So coronavirus is a droplet infection, while TB is a droplet nuclear infection, which makes it airborne, meaning that it can stay suspended in the air for a long period of time. And people that come in contact with the germ get
beyond
infected.
Beyond 24 hours?
Beyond 24 hours, yes.
Okay, now some people have, shall I say, an impression or a myth about a TB not being curable, that it can be managed but not totally curable. Do you want to shed light on this?
TB is very curable. In Nigeria right now, we cure about 87% of the cases of TB that we detect, meaning that out of 10 people that have TB, almost 9 of them will be cured. So it is curable, and we have very effective drugs for all forms of TB.
Now, I want to ask, are there limiting factors to the cure of TB in Nigeria, and can it totally be eliminated from the country?
TB can be eliminated. We know that we can't eliminate it alone by working with the health system. It has to be a multi-sectoral approach, because as you may be aware, that TB is associated with poverty, undernutrition, and overcrowding, and poor housing, of course.
Okay.
So there are social aspects of the disease.
Poor hygiene, can that also contribute to the infection?
Yes, you don't
of TB?
Have good cough etiquette.
Okay.
Not dirty environment, but cough etiquette, so to speak. So the same. That's why the preventive measures for TB are so similar to the preventive measures for COVID virus. Because the same cough etiquette, cough hygiene, ensuring that you cough properly, cough into your elbows, you know, not spitting, you know, on the floor, yeah. or not your phlegm, when you produce phlegm, don't just spit it anywhere. They are the same preventive measures for TB. So with proper awareness creation, with proper education of the population, with proper improvements in the socioeconomic status of people, TB can be eliminated.
All right. Now, March 24 every year has been earmarked World Tuberculosis Day. And yeah. so you want to shed more light on that. Today happens to be 24th of March. And so yeah. today is World Tuberculosis Day. Yeah. So what are the activities lined up for today in commemoration of World Tuberculosis Day?
Yeah. So like you rightly said, March 24th is the day when we commemorate the World TB Day on a yearly basis. It happens to be the day that the person that discovered the germ, Robert Koch, identified the bacteria that causes TB. It was on March 24th. So that's why every year we remember what is work, we remember the people that have TB, and we re-energize ourselves to fight TB. We had lined up quite a number of activities, not just for today, but for a week-long celebration okay. and commemoration. Unfortunately, the COVID-19
is taking the pandemic, front burner.
It's taking the front burner.
Yes.
And in the spirit of social distancing and, sanitizing the environment, we have stepped down in a lot of activities that we would have done both in Lagos and in Abuja to commemorate the World TB Day. Okay. A few activities are still going on, and thankfully, like this broadcast, that we are maintaining a very healthy distance, and this place is not crowded. So we are happy that this is still going on. But we had planned for outreaches, we had planned for rallies, we had planned a lot of things that we had to cancel because of the COVID-19 virus. But it's okay because, like I said, the preventive measures are very similar.
Okay. Now, there's so much emphasis and the focus is on COVID-19 right now. Because I know there's a vision 2030 to eliminate TB completely. Yeah. Do you see that still being realistic in the light of the recent COVID-19?
I'm very optimistic. And if there's anything COVID-19 has done for TB, it is creating awareness about lung health and respiratory diseases.
Okay.
The way you prevent COVID-19 is the way you also prevent transmission of TB. Maybe not exactly the same way, but some basic cough hygiene measures.
Okay.
We've been teaching people for years to cough into their elbows, and we found it difficult. But lo and behold, COVID-19 came, and everybody now knows they should cough into their elbows and not into their palms or not into the open air. So I believe that we might have lost a bit of ground in terms of celebrating March, 24. World TB Day, but actually gained a lot more in creating awareness about respiratory diseases.
Great. Dr. Bolanle Olusola-Faleye, the Technical Director, Shops Plus TB Program, thank you for joining us this morning and for your insightful contribution on tuberculosis.
Thank you for having me.